Day two, or review two for solutions, chapter seven, for CE chemistry. Okay, so we need to review the colligative properties. When we review the colligative properties have to do with solutions. So you've dissolved something into a solvent. You have a solute and a solvent minimum. So when I do that, my freezing point is depressed. So I have freezing point depression, it goes down. Boiling point is elevated, it goes up. Vapor pressure, that means how much will it go into a vapor above the liquid, is lowered, and osmosis is possible. So with the first two, we know we have the equation delta T is equal to the molality, and remember, molality is equal to moles divided by kilograms, and that's moles of solute divided by kilograms of solvent. Okay, molality times a constant times I, and I is the number of ions that it will break into. So remember that carbon compounds or things that are molecularly bound will not break up, like sand, SiO2, will not break up. It'll be an I of one. Now for our K, we have a KB, which is 0.52. Remember that I add that to 100 degrees to get my delta T, I add it to 100 degrees. Let me fix that a little bit. Whoa! Okay, so I add delta T to 100 degrees to get my new boiling point. Now for KF, or K freezing, I use a negative 1.86 degrees. And when I get done, that will be my new temperature when I put it into this equation right here. That'll be my new temperature, as long as I put the negative in front of it. Now on the test, it might not have the negative. Just remember that you subtract it from zero. That's why I put the negative there. Okay, but that number will be given to you on the test. All right, vapor pressure lowering. So if I have, I wanna know how much vapor is above a liquid. If I have a pure substance, it's going to be higher than if I put it with